Well, people in Pocatello have been noticing different flight patterns over their city in the past few weeks. KPVI News That Works For You reporter Zane Hopin joins us live in the newsroom to let everyone know there's no reason to worry. Zane.
Thanks, Marlies. For about 30 years, Pocatello's played a big role in battling fires through the air, but this year they've had to step it up a notch in just about every way.
It's supposed to be the tail end of fire season. But between the Roosevelt, Martin Creek, 8 Mile fires, and others, this record-breaking year doesn't seem to be slowing down anytime soon. And in Pocatello, that means more air traffic.
You'll see those aircraft coming and going several times a day. Every hour, they'll pick up retardant, they'll go drop, and then they'll come back and pick up more and go drop.
Pocatello Regional Airport has been home base for the region's BLM aerial firefighters since the late 80s following the Johnny Creek fire in 1987. Right now, it's housing a double-digit number of planes that drop retardant on regional fires every day. They leave at sunrise and return at sunset. And the increased air traffic hasn't gone unnoticed by the Pocatello community.
They use some really large aircraft sometimes to fight the fires, and those do make a lot of noise. They also look a lot closer because they're a lot larger than the normal commercial aircraft that we have flying out.
And if you're thinking this air traffic is higher than in past years, you're right. BLM's record high for retardant used in one fire season is 1.5 million gallons. They've used 2.8 million so far this season. When the DC-10 tanker arrived in Pocatello a few years ago, they were told there would never be more than one present at a time. And for much of this season, there have been three.
Their activity is really based on what fires are going on, and if there's an active fire, they could sit here and not be going anywhere.
But unfortunately this season, that's rarely been the case.
Hines added that the airport is proud to lease the land out to the BLM, who saved lives and land all over the region. Live in the newsroom, I'm Zane Hopin. Marlies, back to you.
All right, thank you so much, Zane.